The rules of the game is that we have to use everything that is given to the person and figure out a way to do it. And you can add materials, do whatever you want with it. It doesn't all have to be in one DIY, but it has to be used some way or another. I'm interested to see what Danny gives me.
DIYer.
If you're coming in from Danny's channel, welcome. I do home and fashion DIY with a lot of thrift flips, and you can subscribe and join the family as I renovate and DIY my way through my first home in 2021. Danny and I were talking last year. We wanted to make a video together. The plan originally was to go to the thrift store, thrift together, and find something, but we're currently, if you didn't know, in a pandemic, so nothing is open right now. So we came up with the idea of looking for things around the house that we no longer want, or I don't have any idea what to do with, and switching with each other to do our own thrift flip home decor. But this is what I have for her. So I have, you remember IKEA had a dresser recall a while ago, and these two pieces were on top of the dressers, but I kept these. This is a very sentimental item to me, and one of its legs broke off. It's actually an eraser, but I don't think it erases, but I think Danny would appreciate something like this. And then a piece of fabric.
I think for funsies, I'm gonna throw this in there too, just to throw a wrench into her creative process.
So let's go hand this off to Danny.
What is that? What? What is?
That's Thrifty Bob!
What is this?
Daddy?
It holds candles.
Okay, this I like.
Do you think that's a cigarette or a cigar after?
I think it's a jewelry thing.
Oh.
This, I thrifted with you, the salad tossers. Okay, okay.
But are they salad tossers?
Or there's something else. Live, laugh, love. Oh no, good vibes. Good vibes. Daddy's favorite.
All right, this is what we got. God, I could take it off the base. I think it would look great black. So this is going in my fireplace. So this lovingly handmade candelabra, I'm going to be sawing it down with a new oval base, salvaging what I can of the original.
And you probably gotta hold the table. The table's gonna be like...
I took off the candlesticks and had no problem going through the wood with a jigsaw. Even cutting the rounded edges was simple, though I had to sand down the corners. I prepped the other candlesticks as well by sanding them down so that they can be spray painted. I flipped the base so that I can have an unmarked surface to replant my candlesticks and drilled a shallow pilot hole spaced evenly along the base. Then glued down with construction adhesive, which is very extra, but I don't have wood glue at the moment. I mean, it was fine. Thank you so much for giving me... It feels like we're being homeschooled during the pandemic and I'm handing over to the teacher my assignment. This?
Oh my god, I love it! The way you cut the base?
Yeah, I cut it into it. So I ended up using the base. I didn't think I would. But I feel like this would look so good with drip, candle drips.
It looks so much more modern and, you know, like updated.
So this, I think what I'm going to do is turn this into a hinged box. I kind of wish I kept the fabric because that would have been a pretty decent cover. Initially, I thought I would add handles to the frame to turn it into a tray as well as box, but I didn't end up liking how the handles looked and skipped them. You may have already seen this DIY all over Pinterest, but I'm going to add a special touch to it just to leave my style on it. I took the frames apart and set it aside, then marked in thirds where I would screw in 1-inch hinges, starting with pilot holes first before screwing in. On the other side, I added a hook and staple in the center for a simple latch. I then had to clean all the glue and paper residue on the backs of the frame. Unfortunately, the good vibes had to go. With a thick brush, I coated two generous layers of acrylic, with the final coat having intentional swirls for a textured finish. On the glass, I painted on groovy swoops, a light blue to match my rug, then darker blue as a shadow. I made a lockbox.
Oh my god, look at you go!
I drilled it myself with 1/64th drill bit. This is the good vibes part. Both of these are painted over. And then yeah. I painted under the glass so that you could put stuff on it. But yeah.
I would have never thought to do that with the frames. Yeah. That's why I'm so glad I gave them to you.
This, I think, if there's some way I can attach this and then take this off. Yeah, I could definitely take this off. I was thinking the brass handle is the only thing I ended up not using out of all these items. I sanded down the whole surface and glued the hands to the tray, experimenting with off-kiltered angles but settling with a simpler look of centered. Then spray painted with a cream color. I wanted a speckled look and tried this with a paintbrush and two different types of greens. It wasn't quite what I was trying to achieve, and I think dotting on with a pen would have been a better look. I also used wood filler where it used to have leather ties attached, but definitely should have done this before spray painting.
Salad fingers!
What are you going to use it for? Is it like for your jewelry?
Yeah, it's a perfect jewelry dish because you could throw rings in here and then you can hang necklaces.
I was also thinking you could put that on your desk and it could like be in mail slot holders.
Yes, even as a desktop thing for paper clips. Yeah, good point.
Way to go, girl. High five to us. Oh, no.
Okay, stare at my elbow and you'll get it right. Ready?
Ready?
So I hope you enjoyed this video. This was very creatively challenging. Thank you, Danny, for your contributions. Don't forget to go over to Danny's channel to check out all of her amazing DIYs. She is an incredible creator, and I truly aspire to be on her level one day. She's taught me so much technical skills, but also just seeing how her creative mind works is incredible. She's truly one of the greats out here on YouTube, and you're really missing out if you're not already subscribed to her channel. If you want to see more from me, you can find me on Instagram at Letitia Q. Be sure to subscribe to this channel and turn on notifications to support, and I will see you next time. I have to show you what I got today. This was the errand that I was running. I went to Home Depot and I rented a van. And because this guy was giving away this table for free, and I'm gonna upcycle it. It's a conference table. So
it's curved.
It's oval, two half oval bases. I'm gonna cut and flute it all around.